anti-SARS molecule evaluated against COVID-19. With a high demand for COVID-19 treatments, research groups work around the clock to determine the next best candidate. At the University of Montreal, or UDEM, a professor had an idea. Why not evaluate the inhibition capacity of a commercially available molecule called VE607 on the virus causing COVID-19? In medicine, inhibitors are a class of drugs designed to interfere with biochemical processes, usually enzymes. Inhibitors work by releasing compounds that bind to active sites of a target enzyme, lowering its concentration. Many antivirals use inhibitors to disrupt the replication process of targeted viruses. Neuraminidase inhibitors, for example, can block an enzyme to stop the release of viruses from infected cells. These are now part of certain flu medications. The opposite of inhibitors are inducers, which enable or boost enzyme production. At UDEM, Professor Christian Barron wondered if the molecule VE607 could also work against the COVID-19 virus. Back in 2004, experts discovered VE607 as a potential weapon against SARS. However, SARS ended quickly, which canceled further development of this molecule. Since SARS and COVID-19 have closely related viruses, reviving the project may be worth it. Barron discussed with UDEM virologist Andres Finzi. We had already tried to reuse other existing molecules and the results were mixed. But since then, we discovered that VE607 works well with all the SARS-CoV-2 variants, Alpha, Beta, Gamma, Delta, and Omicron. All of them were inhibited, Finzi stated. In a preprint uploaded on BioRxiv, the team tested the molecule against the COVID-19 virus. VE607 demonstrated the ability to attach itself to the key of the virus that infects cells. The molecule could freeze in a specific form, disabling chances to unlock healthy cells. On top of that, the VE607 could stabilize the receptor binding domain in its up position. Locking RBD in that position is important, for it can show experts why even variants were inhibited. Despite the promising inhibitory prowess of the molecule, the development of new drugs based on it may take a year at least. There are several factors that need to be assessed, including optimized form, safety, and efficacy. Plus, lab results don't automatically translate the same in clinical trials. Enzyme inhibitors have advantages and can potentially improve the lives of many suffering from chronic illnesses. But inhibitors can have downsides because they decrease enzyme-related processes. Decreasing these processes may open risks, which are something benefits must outweigh. So, developing just one inhibitor as a treatment for a disease can be a tall order. It must offer more benefits than risks, if not a very good balance. What do you think about reviving the anti-SARS molecule for COVID-19? Do you know someone who is taking any kind of inhibitor? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.